I can't hear red.
Is it on there?
Yep. Is his mic on?
Yes, it's on.
Yes, it's on.
It's on.
Hey, it is on.
It's that we didn't have anybody in audio.
We just didn't have somebody in audio. That's why. Sorry. Okay, let's start again. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go red. I can't hear anything.
That was the second one?
I can barely.
I gotta run down just to make sure.
Can we have
first game
red mics?
His mic's fine.
But no, I mean, like, can we hear him more?
11 to 8 and 10 to 5.
What are you talking about?
Like, to have more volume on what he's saying.
Single game against Washi Combat.
His audio is good. I'm not gonna turn it up anymore in there. And I've got it as loud as it goes in here.
Okay.
Ozark's athletics has been fortunate enough to enjoy great highs on the videos. And there have been many people who have played a role. Ozark's contributing backpack journalist, Christian Johnson, has a story on the man behind it all.
And then we would say that. Awesome. Very interesting.
Okay. How did you feel? Like, what's your
favorite color?
It's okay.
Hello, but in the eye, what's your favorite color? Oh, dang it. I didn't see.
Does he want to try it again?
Yeah.
Okay, let's go with the sports segment again. But isn't he sharing the same with Brett?
But they're unaware.
Not this time.
Oh, that'll be right before break one.
Yeah, that's a good idea. Can we test Mike? Dax's mic. Now that all of them fail, have either.
Thank you.
You want to
do? Then I'll go break
too. No, let's test Dax's mic.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, Dax, do the thing.
Do the thing.
The weather thing.
Oh.
Dang it. Oh.
I was gonna say, huh?
That's very loud.
Tell me when they're ready.
Okay.
Are you guys ready?
Yeah. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. It has been a cool day today with highs only in the 50s, which is well below average for mid-April, but that is nothing compared to what we saw. Good?
Yeah, he's good. Okay. Good. Okay, we have 8 minutes till we start.
And then break four.
Where did Tana go?
Grandstand.
Another break.
Do a little Facebook Live right here right now.
She said she would.
Are you guys?
No.
Where did you go?
No,
Anna?
Sit down. You get back over there.
I was going to make sure Nike said
that. Oh, yeah. Do what you need to.
Oh, I suddenly have to go to the bathroom. Oh, no.
Oops. Sit still.
Are we getting a picture after a show?
We'll have to do it after,
yeah. Well, not
I don't
exactly,
want to give Bette a heart attack.
We do come back
we have
with...
Time. We can take it right now.
Kieran
you're like on the edge
of life.
Always.
What?
No, he's scaring me, as usual.
Luis?
That was not the time for this.
I know.
Thank you.
It's okay.
Are those your right graphics?
Is that it?
Those are right graphics.
For red?
No, the
credits.
That was the one that was in there. Credits 3. Play it again. Credits.
So.
No.
The right ones
are no.
Because we're rolling them over black, right? We're not using the green screen for the credits today.
No.
Is that what you're saying?
No.
Yes.
Those are the ones from last week.
Okay, we want the ones from this week that have her as the director that roll over black. Remember?
Yeah.
Because we don't want Roman. Okay. And where are they? Should this
there.
Be them? There. Are they labeled? Did you say 3?
Yes.
That's what
they are green too.
Does that say three on there?
It does.
Mm-hmm. Okay, how about if you go with Louise and see if you if what you guys are looking at is the same thing.
3 minutes to go.
Okay, let's go ahead and switch that from tightrope to live. So it's the other blue tape on the top rope. Good.
Okay.
That means any audio, any video that's in program. So let's take the satellite out of program. There you go. Thank you. That's going out. Cool.
Okay, so why don't you put...
Yeah, I'm going to go ahead and run audio because they're trying to deal with stuff.
Okay.
Somebody's going to have to run the teleprompter.
Do we have it?
Will I have to do?
Okay, let me try to get it.
No.
We don't have anything in Blackstar.
Again.
Part two.
Living it up.
Okay.
We're never going to make it on time, are we?
Okay, we have 3 minutes to sell these.
We need to start sacrificing.
We need to start, like, improvising. Improvising intros.
No, I guess that in worst case scenario, we'll just start a little bit later.
You can turn on this camera and we can just perform.
I wonder what is Kieran saying, but he has to be muted.
Are we gonna faint? Are we gonna be fainting? Cool.
So he's going in there right now to try to reload it.
Okay. Is it gone because we have the Gronk credit, so he had to do it again?
I don't know.
No, I'm not talking to you, sorry.
I don't know. At 7 o'clock.
We got stuff.
Hey, at
Woo!
7 o'clock.
Push record.
Push record.
Did you reject it?
Go ahead and push record now in both places.
Yeah, in
at 7 o'clock, bring Carmen's picture up.
And just, okay.
Okay.
Because you went to take out something.
All right.
You want to put in something?
Yeah, but I didn't.
Hey, do you need me to run the teleprompter while you guys, while you work on the other
yes.
thing?
Yes.
Okay. I got teleprompter.
Hey,
you got audio.
Yeah.
Okay.
We're going to be putting the expression.
We have a little bit less than a minute.
But, yes, Memorial will be in expression.
Where's the record?
It's already recorded.
Okay.
There.
Back there.
Oh. You're good. Okay, we're live on channel 6. We have 30 seconds.
Oh wow.
Yeah.
Hang on, stay on that. Don't get off of that yet.
Okay. JK, it's gonna be like 30 seconds.
Maybe we're taking a silent time.
Right.
Huh. A minute. Well, at least we started on time.
Yep.
It's gonna be like an entire minute.
Yep.
Okay. Ready? Do a 10-second countdown.
Okay. Nine. 10, 9, 8.
Ready, Blackstorm.
7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Take Blackstorm.
Your source for television news, weather, sports, current events, and
turn
musical entertainment from the University of Wills Arts in Clarksville, Arkansas. This
turn
is
up
Ozarks
Bradley.
Today.
Okay.
On today's show, local teams...
So can you give me a countdown?
Ozark Avenue,
please.
Field Day, and honor art, culture, and the memory of a friend. Plus weather with Dax Clark. Eagle Sports with Brett Williamson, and this week's In Focus interview segment hosted by Lily Marlin. And the sounds of the Ozark Mountains fill the air
What's
as the Mountain Rangers round
yeah.
out this season
okay.
from the Walker Hall
we'll
section.
Okay, be ready to go.
30 seconds.
Oh, 10.
Go.
Go, Kiernan. Go.
Top of our news tonight, two
ready.
Local teens prepare to go to a national 4-H competition that might just surprise you.
Lower third?
Gavin Wheeler is here to help us to take the plunge.
Take package.
Every Friday,
after school,
she comes to...
Okay. He speaks for more time here, so we can see the lower third.
Okay, well, I think it's counting up rather than down now, so...
Yeah.
But Savannah and Abby do not practice swimming at the Clarksville Aquatic Center.
Here.
Instead,
the runtime
says
how
into practicing
how much
for an aquatic
they
robotics competition.
So, that should help.
Effort over the past 3 years of kind of our team has dwindled, but it's really been the two of us doing a lot with our team.
You do.
This is the challenge course, and basically, what you do is you get the sea perch, and it has a little book on it, and you try and pick it up with your foot. And you want to move it to this platform. This, as you can see, it has a top and a bottom. So this, the top, is worth 2 points, and the bottom is worth 1 point. So in the obstacle course, there's a series of hula hoops, smaller hula hoops.
What?
Sat at different angles, or things
so
with the same
voice
through all the hula hoops and then surface. And the judge will tell you when you go surface and then you come back. So when you go surface,
okay.
You go down and you just go right back to the other hoops and you go back. Yeah, I am the driver.
This is the wrong one.
The spotter.
This is
so
the wrong one.
Here, the driver, you have spotters, and the spotter helps
yeah,
a lot.
My fault.
Sometimes
I think I put the wrong one in.
But
I can fix that when I edit it.
Last year we were not able to at nationals, but we did
15 seconds.
15 seconds.
Nationals.
Ten, nine.
They will be off to compete at nationals in a few weeks.
Four,
I'm Gavin Wheeler, signing off with KOZ 6HD.
Clarksville Light and Water Company is unique in many ways. It is a city-owned utility belonging to the citizens of Clarksville, rather than to an outside company. While the utility currently provides electric, water, and sewer services, this unique entity is moving beyond these fundamental services for a small town into truly progressive territory with the recently installed fiber optic data cable throughout the city and the state's largest municipal solar farm. Here's Jada Wright with a further insight from a tool designed especially for staff and students from the U of O.
Take package.
A group from the University of the Ozarks recently went on a trial technology to view the new solar farm that was implanted by a Clarksville Light and Water Company. Mr. John asked them walking through the process of what they will expect from the new solar farm.
We want to be able to deliver these things cheaper, better, faster than what most communities can do.
Mr. John Lester explains how not only the university can benefit from this, but the community as well.
The university benefits by having some exposure for itself, by being within a community that's progressive and forward-thinking, and part of our supply is sustainable material energy, and University of Ozarks get a part of that supply. The goal for the solar plant is to produce the maximum amount of energy on a solar basis at the peak time. It's a peak shaver for us and to save money for our customers.
One of our very own teachers, Dr. Chris Carrier, describes his experience at the solar farm.
It was terrific. It was nice to see
30 seconds.
Some of the facilities, particularly the solar field, which I'd seen from the road, but got to be up inside it and learn a little bit about how it works. And it was nice to learn about some of these things that I'd only been hearing about.
We have a 5-megawatt power plant, and it's right here within our footprint. That's generation that's delivered and produced by the most natural resource you can have is the sun.
Art and culture are often paired. In this next story by Hannah Bredo, we see a meaningful connection between people, cultures, art, and memory.
art show at University of the Ozarks, several students came together to present their ideas of culture through their pieces.
Culture, to me, is like a big umbrella term that is really kind of like the way people live and like the things that they relate to. And so to me, it just kind of like shows what people really love and what they care about and like their background, I guess.
As art students across the school expressed their ideas of culture, they also created an interactive installation to invite everyone to share their cultures.
There's so many different cultures. We want people to be able to, I guess, pay homage to their culture and either like a word or a phrase or like their definition of culture.
Oddly, I also think about culture connected to food. So I also think about the way that culture can change flavors in kind of really interesting things to eat.
There are several creative installations within the art show, but this year's show is a little different as art students came together to create an
one-minute
installation
for
Carmen Castorena, an alumni who recently passed in a tragic car accident.
I was excited that the students wanted to have a memorial piece for her, but it was very bittersweet. I just feel a great loss to our community. She was a voice that we really needed to have. She would always bring people together. She would help people and teach people and kind of build bridges in between other people. And so that's something I also really appreciated about her. It's like not everyone has that capacity to reach out and connect.
Okay, so I got the new credits on there, but I don't want to take it out until Dax's.
A lot of people say they don't even know how they met her, but she's kind of like talking to their lives. And so she's always just like this ray of sunshine. We wanted to pay homage to like her and like show how like bright and happy she was and like reference one of the things that she liked, like the cat diver and pieces and things like that.
This has been Hannah Freeland, Ozarks to Divide, KUOZ 6-3-2-1,
go Kiernan.
This year, the University of the Ozarks is celebrating several national titles in multiple sports, but perhaps one of the events we're most proud of is the time athletes and coaches set aside each year to make new friends in the community. It was my honor to report on this very special day.
Take by, Coach.
Hey, instead of doing that countdown, I'm pretty familiar with the stories. What I'd rather do is, as soon as we're into the buffer, we're going to cut, or we're going to go back to that shot, because we're missing it a little bit. We're hitting it in black.
On Thursday, April 12th, University of the Ozarks athletes spent time with the self-contained special education classrooms in Clarksville and Lamar, making arts and crafts, playing tennis, shooting hoops, playing soccer, but most importantly, making new friends.
Visitors are often not included in other activities on their campuses, so by bringing it here, they get a special opportunity to not only enjoy our beautiful campus, but to make some new friends with the what we call the bigs, the university students and athletes.
Because it brings our community together, not only our campus community, but like our local community.
So much mutual connectedness for the kids to come out here and to get to experience what we experience, and as a unit together, it's just life enhancing style that I can put it.
The experiences between the athletes and students this day are ones they sure aren't to forget, and the memories made are sure to last a lifetime. This is the Kiernan Blocksmeyer with KUOZ 6 HD.
Okay, go Kiernan.
April is the national month of, well, lots of things, not the least
right.
of which is poetry. As Bradley Thompson reports, famous and sometimes emphatically infamous Project Poet made a special one-night-only extra appearance last week.
Take package.
Members of the Ozarks community are finding creative ways to celebrate their love of poetry in honor of April being considered National Poetry Month. Among various other activities around campus this month, students can spectate and participate in a special one-night-only version of the beloved Battle Royale Poetry Slam competition, Project Poet. As usual, the event is emceed by Ozarks professor and poet Dr. Chris Carrier. To mix things up, though, the judge table this time around is made up exclusively of finalists from the Project Poet season last fall.
I feel kind of bad judging. I feel like I'm harping on people because it's always hard just going up there and giving it your all. There are different kinds of poems about the world, poems about themselves. It was just kind of neat to hear everyone's views on this theme of globalization and how it relates to everything.
Globalization has been the theme this past week here at Ozarks, Project Poet being just one of the ways students can express themselves on the topic of culture and engaging with the larger world.
And it's a platform that people can be honest.
just about themselves and about their views of the world, because I mean, like, when we're talking about reporting, it's pretty controversial stuff, especially where we're located. And I think to have this kind of platform where people are willing to, like, listen to what you have to say, I mean, that's the magic of this event.
This land was supposed to be a melting pot of people, a simple goal with a simple purpose. Instead of melting together, it seems the pot has caused confusion across the whole spectrum.
I just think it's really exciting to be on a campus where people will take time to celebrate creative endeavors. It's exciting to be in that vibrant, creative community, and I'm glad that people here are excited to support that.
So it's always been a really special place in my heart, and I really hope that we can keep this project going.
Michael Phelps holds the record for the most Olympic medals won at a single Olympic game. He's a household name and once said, quote, "Swimming is normal for me. I'm relaxed, I'm comfortable, and I know my surroundings," end quote. Reporter Hannah Barreto introduces us to a local swimming phenom who shares Phelps' affinity for the water and may one day be staying on his footsteps on the podium.
Take package.
Making waves at the local aquatic center.
We're coming back, Kiernan, and then we have to have the creative camera ready. Because after these, we're going on break.
According to the coach, David DeGuys, Chloe has been breaking records throughout her career in swimming.
And a couple of them she has broken several times. She had almost every freestyle record, I believe.
How long? Waiting in the water has always been
a challenge.
As she tells us,
it'll be on for a little bit.
So what I thought he'd say something like, ready, flex, or more, and then really
Before you do that, though, I want to give it a couple of seconds.
That same
moment,
the water has pushed Chloe to
the best. Because I want it to capture what's going to happen. But yeah, that's a good idea.
Chloe shares his plans for her moving forward.
She goes into high school next year, so I'm really hoping that she can kind of get recognized at high school level. I want to get her to top three at least in state. All the freshman year, I'm really working on that for high school. And moving forward, I want to prepare her for college. No matter where she goes, all the different sports, any college she wants to go to, I want her to push herself.
This has been Hannah Brady with Ozarks Today on KUOZ 6HD1.
Stay tuned. We have a lot more for you on Ozarks Today, including sports with Rhett Williamson, an expert on autism, talks with Lily Marlowe in this week's In Focus, some homegrown music from the Mountain Boomers, and the ever-changing spring weather with Dax Clark. But first, I'd like to show you something you normally don't get to see on our show.
Okay.
The crew working in the control room. Tonight's show is being directed by Barry Osorio, and just about now, you'll see her. What she doesn't know is that since she's graduating in a couple of short weeks, we have a surprise for her.
You know, I kind of figured you would do something like this.
Roll it. Roll it back.
Okay, I'm going to turn the camera off.
Okay, so
Barry,
you're she was there to help me with my first project, and she's always been there, helpful and willing to help me through whatever I've needed help with, and I really appreciate it for that.
Barry is a very helpful person. When I first came here, she was my OE mentor, and I see how easy the whole process of moving in and becoming more comfortable here at Ozark. And congratulations on graduating. You're welcome.
We're all gonna miss you. I'm gonna miss you a lot. This year has been lots of fun. You've watched me lay on many different things that shouldn't be laid on. Given me a couple of pretty interesting nicknames. And I think we've had fun and been great. It's good. See you later.
So awkward.
Congratulations, Barry, for graduating. It's been really cool knowing you for like the last semester or so. Even though I'm just a freshman just coming in. Sad that you're already leaving, but I wish you good luck on your future, wherever you end up. Congratulations.
congratulations on graduating, Barry. I'm going to miss you. I worked with you for about 90% of my stories. You were my producer, which was great. I loved working with you at the Hot Springs Film Festival, and I even had a lot of fun doing that freelance photography work that we did while we were down there at Hot Springs. So I'm going to miss you. Good luck on what you do, Barry.
Thank you. I'm really going to miss you. You really helped me along in all of this, and I don't know what I could have done without you. The countless times you've checked me out and helped me when I was in a tough spot, the editing, everything. And I just wish you all the best with whatever it is that you choose to do, because you know what? You're going to be awesome at whatever you do.
Thank you, Hannah.
Hey, Soria, what can I say that hasn't already been said? Oh, yeah, you've dealt with me for the past year. That alone is a challenge, so to be able to do that and graduate, to that,
what
I congratulate you. Good luck out there.
Betty, you are a really awesome producer. You're one of a kind. You've helped me a lot throughout the time I've been in Media Productions 1 and 2. You've taught me a lot of tricks on how to edit my videos, and I just thank you for it. And I hope whatever you do in the future, you're awesome at it. Love you.
Hey, Betty, it's been a pleasure working alongside you and being a co-producer.
Oh, my God.
especially, you know, your positivity and how you're always looking on the bright side of things, and I know that you're going to be successful wherever you go, no matter what you do, and you're going to be missed.
So sweet.
I just want to wish you the best. I know you're going to success in the coming years, and thank you very much for everything.
So, Betta, you're leaving us.
Aww.
Who's going to come to my house and color? I don't know. We'll miss you so much. You did a documentary. You did a Spanish soap opera. You were awesome. Come back and see us.
Barry, I hear that you're getting the boot. That's pretty awesome. Congratulations. It was very nice getting to know you over this last year, and I wish you the very, very best.
It's really been a pleasure working with you as a student and as an advisee and as a friend. I remember the time that you and Cheryl came out and cooked food and you made a flan for us.
Oh, that I
burned. Great experience, great memory. And I also want to apologize that in 4 years I have not yet said your name correctly. I always end up saying it kind of like Barry. But you know, in some ways I think that's appropriate because you're just as sweet as any kind of Barry.
Oh.
And I hope you have a great future ahead of you. Well, Betty, I have some bad news for you. I've been able to access your grades. Sorry. Yeah. I'm afraid the time has come and we're going to have to say goodbye. But we want you to know how special you are, and we really appreciate everything that you've done while you've been here as a student, not only for the RTV program, but for the choir, the sociology program, and just all the people that you've touched in such a positive way. We're going to miss you.
Oh my God. Stand by. Oh God. Go creative fam. Oh, sorry. Stay on that. Stay on that. Go back. Bring that up. Thank you. Creative fam.
That is so sweet, guys. Thank you so much.
Okay, Blackstorm 1. Go Blackstorm 1.
Okay, go Blackstorm 1.
Guess who made that video?
Yeah. I figured you would do something like that.
All the rest of them we go.
We conspire in positive ways. Okay, let's get Dax set up. Where do you want him?
Okay. Wait, but he's not coming back with that graphic. He's coming back with
one.
Well, either way, we need him.
Is that the first
graphic?
That
is the first graphic.
Yes. That's the first graphic?
Yes.
We're trying
to talk
about the tornadoes. Oh, okay.
Okay.
Can I have, Jada, can you zoom out a little bit?
Just to talk.
No.
Go back. He's good
so
right there.
Can
we just tilt it?
Fish, gar, whatever.
Yeah, tilt
we're going to have a separate pot for that, just to kind of make it a little more fun. So, yeah, there's several different opportunities out here
good.
For people to win some money and some good prizes.
It is.
At the end of the year, we will determine scholarship for area youth that's going to get into either law enforcement or any type of public service. You know, we're just going to come out here, we're going to have fun, and like support a great cause, and every year it's just amazing to see everybody come together to help us out. You know, great community, great sponsors, great fishermen. We've been asked for anything more.
KUOZ 6 HD weather forecaster, Dax Clark.
Well, good afternoon, everyone. It's been a pretty cool day out there, and really over the past several days, but this time last week, it was not the same situation. We were talking about potential for tornadoes and severe weather, and unfortunately, that happened. So let's kind of give a recap of what happened last week. So far, the National Weather Service has confirmed 13 tornadoes in the state of Arkansas, meeting the criteria for an outbreak, including one in Johnson County. And this one was up near Ozone. It was an EF1 tornado. Had a path around 5 miles, winds up to 110 miles an hour. It was 250 yards wide. Thankfully, the storm developed well north of the city of Clarksville and was moving away at the time, so we didn't have to deal with any of the tornado threat in Clarksville. Now, however, taking a look at where it tracked, it did track in between Salus and Ozone, damaged a lot of the trees in the Ozark National Forest, as well as a couple of homes, tearing off some of those roofs and then downing power lines, knocking out power to portions of the Ozark National Forest area. Now, one of the bigger stories in the area, one of the biggest tornadoes Arkansas has seen in quite some time, unfortunately also struck very close to our area, the Mountainburg tornado, rated an EF2, that is considered strong on the enhanced Bedelia scale. It was more long track, about 11 miles it was on the ground, with winds as high as 130 miles an hour. We've obtained some pictures also that we're going to use from our friends at KFSM. Look at this thing. It was a half mile wide, and this is why we were talking about the potential for long track tornadoes and strong tornadoes, and this one by all means was. Take a look at the damage that you can see here on their Sky5 cam, again from our friends at KFSM. A lot of damage and destruction.
He just had to
out
load
there
that.
In Mountainburg,
had to do it during
over
this.
Half the town
okay.
reportedly sustained damage, and they are still dealing with that this week. You can see this house right here just wiped clear off the foundation as winds over 120 to 130 miles an hour raked the city. You can see here it touched down around Rudy and then continued to cross.
Welcome back, everyone, and again, thank you for joining us for the show this spring. We have a lot of people to thank, including you, our viewers, our story subjects, and all of the reporters and crew. One of the highlights of the show this season would have to be our musical guests, appearing on what we call Walker Hall Sessions, named after the Walker Hall Teacher Education and Communication Building that houses our broadcast studio. This week, we've got a treat for you from right here in Clarksville, Arkansas. We're proud to present the Mountain Boomers.
Good job. Okay, get in there and get your picture. Get your picture made. All right, you got one of those little timer thingies? Okay. You don't have to talk with that. Audio, and then we stop recording, and then we go back to tightrope.
Very good.
That's
okay, now
wrap.
Don't
for
leave.
Now.
We need to check the recording.
I'll cry.
So, Luis, if you'll get on there and check it, we may have to scroll through the noise. It seemed like it quit about 5 minutes
when
it
was playing.
A little bit, yeah. No, it.